coming up on LUTV News. A new mask mandate is in effect today for St. Louis County. Plus, St. Louis employers are struggling to find new hires. And the Royal Rumble is coming back to St. Louis in the near future. Those stories and more ahead on LUTV News. Welcome to this edition of LUTV News. I'm Alexis Montgomery. The Federal Bureau of Investigation is teaming up with St. Louis City and County Police to track down whoever was responsible for at least three murders. Authorities think three murders that happened over the last week and a half are connected and are looking for any information available. Police say the suspect could exhibit the following characteristics: changes in routine or behavior, altering their appearance, unexplained injuries, and suddenly selling, repairing, or disposing of a vehicle. If you have any information, please contact the Homicide Division at 314-444-5371 or Crime Stoppers. Police are investigating after a man and woman were shot on westbound Interstate 70 in North St. Louis City. The shooting happened late Saturday night. Police say they received a call about the shooting near Madison. At the scene, they found a 27-year-old woman who was shot in the head. Authorities say the victims are at the hospital and in stable condition. Police say they don't have any suspects or a motive. Police are looking for a man and woman who are involved in a crash that killed a man Sunday night in downtown St. Louis. Witnesses say a Ford F-150 and Mercedes-Benz SUV crashed around 11:30 p.m. at Tucker and Locust, after a man and woman got out of the truck and ran. The 46-year-old man and the Mercedes later died at the hospital. Police have not released the man's identity. A St. Louis County municipal judge will not be practicing law for several years after being accused of mismanaging clients' funds. The Missouri Supreme Court suspended Jennifer Fisher's law license after an audit revealed that her client's trust account balances frequently fell below the amount necessary for settlement payments. The disciplinary panel suggested a year of probation, but the disciplinary's counsel office vetoed that recommendation. Fisher's attorney says she is facing multiple personal challenges, including caring for two family members and a personal medical condition. The county's acting health director, Dr. Faisal Khan, has issued a new mask mandate. Despite controversy, County Executive Sam Page sticks to the mandate.
Masks work in helping to keep our cases from escalating in St. Louis County. That's why our health director, Dr. Faisal Khan, will put into place a new public health order requiring masks to be worn. It was signed this morning and goes into effect immediately.
The expectation in the mandate orders people to continue wearing masks in indoor public spaces and are highly encouraged for crowded outdoor venues. Straight ahead on LUTV News, a railway accident over the weekend in Montana left three dead and many injured. Find out what happened when we come back.
When I was in foster care, I never knew when I would have to move, so I always had my suitcase ready to go. Then one day, I was adopted. My new parents opened their hearts and home to me. My parents cook my favorite breakfast for me every morning. My parents take me on trips I never thought I would go on. They gave me a home and an even better reason to use that suitcase. My parents aren't perfect, but they're perfect for me.
I'm Jenny Garth, and as a mother of three, I know kids worry about a lot of things. Getting enough food to eat shouldn't be one of them. But here in America, that is a real worry for one in five children. Even though we are one of the most food-rich countries in the world, 15 million children don't know where their next meal is coming from. This is unacceptable, and something the Feeding America nationwide network of food banks is working to solve. Instead of accepting that our country lets billions of pounds of surplus food go to waste every year, Feeding America has made it their mission to help families in need by rescuing this food. Through food pantries and meal programs, the nationwide network of food banks provides more than 3 billion meals, serving virtually every community in the United States, including yours. Join me in supporting Feeding America and your local food bank by visiting feedingamerica.org. Together, we can solve hunger. Together, we're feeding America.
What do you think you're doing, Kevin?
I was just gonna drive home.
There are several warning signs present that you shouldn't be driving.
Like hearing voices?
Like your text to emoji ratio?
Oh man, the selfies.
Selfies, nailed it.
We all have warning signs that let us know that we're probably not okay to drive. Mine is pretending to be your subconscious.
Craig, come on man, let's put a ride home.
Occurred in Overland after shots were fired at police on Monday. A man and woman in a Mazda with no front bumper were wanted in Overland for firing at an officer. The pair ran out of the car and a chase began. The chase ended in St. Louis City near Norwich and Lillian and were promptly arrested. Three people are dead and seven are hurt after a train derailed in Montana on Saturday. The train was carrying more than 140 passengers and 17 crew members near the Canada border. Nearby communities rushed to help the victims. Some passengers spent the night in a local school. The wreck happened during annual Rail Safety Week. Amtrak CEO says the National Transportation Safety Board is investigating the accident. Angela Merkel will be stepping down after serving as Germany's chancellor for 16 years. Merkel's Christian Democrats Party narrowly lost to the Social Democratic Party. German Vice Chancellor Olaf Scholz leads the Social Democratic Party. He will be up for election as the next possible chancellor. Germany's political parties are still discussing who could potentially be the new chancellor. That decision could take months to finalize. You may see a lot of help wanted signs all over St. Louis soon. St. Louis employers are desperate to hire more people, and some are even offering to pay top dollar to reel them in. Some restaurant owners are saying that they're having to extend business hours to catch up. Those hiring say applicants are asking for high wages, such as $18 hourly wages plus tips. Last month, Missouri added over 7,000 new people to the workforce. Veterans and military members may be able to find work a little easier from home this week. Military X is hosting an online job fair with over 25 employers for veterans, military members, and their spouses. Companies like General Motors, Costco, Wholesale, and Google are participating. The event is on September 28th from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. You can sign up at militaryx.com. Let's get ready to rumble. The WWE's Royal Rumble makes its return to St. Louis on January 29th in 2022. The Royal Rumble will take place in the Dome at America Center, making the largest venue the company has been into in its 30-plus year history. The Dome can host up to 60,000 people. According to the St. Louis Post-Dispatch, more than 40,000 fans are expected to attend come January. The last time the WWE came to St. Louis was back in 2015 at the Gateway to the West, where Missouri native Harley Race had two of his biggest WWE wins. Tickets go on sale on October 15th at 10 a.m. The event will also be streamed on NBC's Peacock streaming service. The Rolling Stones rolled into their No Filter tour in the Dome at America Center yesterday in St. Louis. Sunday, September 26, 2021, was the band's first show without late drummer Charlie Watts. The band dedicated the tour to Watts, and they opened the show with a tribute montage. Frontman Mick Jagger told his fans, "This is our first tour that we've ever done without him, so all the reaction from you guys has been very touching," Jagger said as he held Richard's hand. "We all miss Charlie so much on the stage and off the stage, and we dedicate this tour to Charlie."
Hang up your sweater and cancel that pumpkin spice latte order. Summer weather is not done yet. I'll have your weather report when we come back on the LUTV News.
Here are your AARP top tips on caregiver preparedness during coronavirus. First, form a caregiving team. Create a list of people in your family and friend network who can help with caregiving tasks. Take an inventory of supplies in your loved one's home. Try to have a 2-week supply of essential items. Make a list of the care recipient's medications and medical contacts. Be sure to have prescriptions on hand and ask the pharmacist for an extra 30-day supply. Make a plan to stay connected. To prevent social isolation, set up available technology to help loved ones stay connected and schedule regular chats. Finally, maintain your own self-care. Follow the Centers for Disease Control's guidelines for coronavirus safety. And have a backup plan for care in case you become ill. For more caregiving tips during the coronavirus pandemic, go to aarp.org/caregiving.
Meet the scan. A simple procedure whose mission is to detect lung cancer early.
I'm here to save you!
But I feel fine.
That's great, but you may still be at high risk for lung cancer.
Oh man, that's a new fence.
If you smoke, early detection could save your life. Learn more at savedbythescan.org.
The fall season started last week, but that doesn't mean we've seen the last of summer weather. So you can put away the sweaters and jackets for at least a week. It's currently sunny in St. Charles with winds at 12 miles per hour. The humidity sits at 34%, and we have a 0% chance of rain. Currently, if we travel east, we'll see the St. Louis is at 86 degrees. Moving west, St. Charles is sunny, sitting at 85 degrees, and Maryland Heights sits at 86 degrees. Further west, St. Peter's and O'Fallon are slightly warmer at 87 degrees. For the week, we're looking at some hot weather temperatures and a splash of rain to cool things off a bit. On Monday, there's a high of 92 and a low of 64. Tuesday will bring more of the same with a high of 92 and a low of 63, this time with a 3% chance of rain. On Wednesday, we'll have a high of 90 and a low of 65 with a 6% chance of rain. Thursday drops down a little with a high of 84 and a low of 63 with a 31% chance of rain. And Friday will bring some cloudy weather and the lowest temperatures with a high of 82 and a low of 60 with a 24% chance of rain. That's it for weather. For LUTV News, I'm Christopher Rogers.
Hurricane Sam is brewing over the Atlantic Ocean Monday morning and has been labeled a Category 4 hurricane. The National Hurricane Center says this is the 7th hurricane of the year. So far, Sam's winds are clocking in over 130 miles per hour. Weather watchers say a jet stream could push the hurricane away from the United States or even towards it. If the hurricane hits the U.S., it could track anywhere from Florida to Maine. The hurricane could hit within the next few days.
The Redbirds are on the edge of a breakthrough, keeping their playoff hopes alive. Find out how they did when we come back.
Certain things get reincarnated in your children. My daughter is very much inspired by my wife's artistic pursuits. So my daughter started making necklaces. She makes what we call affirmation fashion. I tell her every day that your black is beautiful. Your black is beautiful. Your black is beautiful. And if there's anything better than being beautiful, it's being smart. And if there's anything better than being smart, it's being kind. And reaffirming that every day is our method of making sure her chin never drops. My dad wasn't around, and I remember riding a bike and falling off and cutting myself, and me never just wanting to get back on it. People ask, how your children learn how to ride a bike, and you did. I didn't teach them. I just created an environment where they taught themselves, and all I had to do was be there.
When you adopt adopt a shelter pet, you discover their unique mix of all kinds of traits.
Where'd Wiley go? Where's Wiley?
Ah, I did.
Pop?
Do you remember being an ancient wolf? Do you ever feel the call of the wild?
You're a renegade cop, and I'm a con woman with nothing to prove. But together, we could really solve this murder.
They're a little bit of a lot of things. But all of them are pure love.
The Cards won their 16th game in a row with a comeback win over the Chicago Cubs. The Cubs took a 2-1 lead in the eighth inning. Center fielder Harrison Bader bashed a solo home run to tie the game. Andrew Kisner scored off a wild pitch at the top of the ninth, and Lars Nootbaar scored the winning run off of an RBI hit from Tyler O'Neill. In the bottom of the ninth, Ian Happ closed the game out with a strikeout on the next at-bat, keeping the Redbirds alive to see another day. The 16-game win streak is the Cards' longest streak since 1951. The Blues are off to a great start this preseason, coming off a 6-2 win over the Minnesota Wild on Saturday. Forward James Neal continues to compete for a spot on the roster, putting on a show with a hat trick to help extend the team's lead. Late in the third, Colton Parayko scored the last goal of the game, giving the Blues their first win in the preseason. The Blues will be back on the ice Monday to face the Dallas Stars at the Enterprise Center. For NFL news, Kansas City Chiefs head coach Andy Reid was hospitalized on Sunday following the team's 30-24 loss to the Los Angeles Chargers. Sources say the 63-year-old coach fell ill and was treated for dehydration. The team said that Reid was doing well and is currently resting in a stable condition. In college football news, the Lindenwood Lions did it again on Saturday, beating Finley University 28-16. Freshman running back Robert Giamo went beast mode, carrying the ball 15 times for 105 yards. He also scored a touchdown that gave the Lions momentum in the second half. Junior quarterback Cade Brister played lights out all around, completing 23 of his passes for 253 yards and scoring 3 touchdowns. The Lions will go back on the road this Saturday to take on Truman State. That's all for AU Sports. For LUTV News, I'm Josh Robinson.
A national winery and restaurant is under construction in the Shops of Mid Rivers and St. Peters. Cooper's Hawk purchased the last outlot at the Shops and is immediately beginning construction. Alan Lloyd, Senior Vice President of Leasing for GBT Realty, said to the St. Louis Business Journal, "The fact that Cooper's Hawk selected St. Peters for its third Missouri location really validates the strength of this secondary market. We absolutely expect this upscale dining experience to quickly become a community favorite and bring a swell of consumer traffic to the shopping center." Haunted houses just got a whole lot scarier this Halloween season. An 11-year-old was stabbed in the foot by an actor in a haunted house in Ohio. The actor was trying to spook the kid by stabbing at the ground, but accidentally stabbed his crotch and got his toe. Staff members gave the child first aid, the knife was taken into police custody, and no charges have been filed. That's it for this edition of LUTV News. I'm Alexis Montgomery. Thanks for joining us.